what the project was. This is OP. Now, I'm telling all the time, the idea that the system failed the youths and made them turn in a killer, or society failed the youths them, is complete rubbish. These youths are being failed by their parents, by their family, by their communities. The idea that these youths are being raised by amazing adults and surrounded by these amazing people, but them just stray from, because the system and society is so powerful, it make them start kill people left, right and center. That's nonsense. The narrative is strong though, I understand, say Jamaica run by narratives. I go make a 87 telling what I'm on about. I was watching a video on YouTube and the 87, right, them interview him, and he said some things where, you know what? I got to play the clip. It's very profound. But before me go any further, I want to send a Patreon radio shout out to Sean, right? Now, Sean, Clarendon man, bro, big up yourself, right? Big up Clarendon as well, you don't know. Beautiful parish, although I'll be a fool, she's not going with. I mean, see one up on murder charts, I go on away, but big up Clarendon, see me. Sean, long time supporter, right? Love for you, you know, you have nothing more respect for the movement, so big up yourself. Right, I'm telling all the time, I'm not stop shout out the Patreon squad. I'm not stop shout out the PIA. These are the people who formed the foundation of the movement. So bro, hope you have a good time. Right? Hope you celebrate and enjoy yourself. And remember, say moderation is the key, right? Let me move into the video. Let me play a clip. This clip is from a YouTube channel called Preflix. P-R-E-E-F-L-I-X. Depending on your screen if I spell it wrong. Right, but Preflix. Now, I want to go over there and support them. Patreon squad PIA, I want to go over there. Let me see, like, them have about 8,999,000. What is that? 8,999 subscribers. Right, so I want to support them because, you know, so when I give shout out, nobody can pay me no amount of money for the shout out. If I was to collect money for the shout out, I would have a yacht like leeching. The amount of money me turned down and left on the board. I don't do short out or promo, but when time I see good content, I have to short it out. So check them out and support them, right? If you want, you know, no one big people, right? Now, I'm going to play the clip. Listen closely, this is like 87 talking.
How did you get into this lifestyle?
Feel like a boy, me born for this, you know, naturally come. It just naturally come, as I say, all of my friends them, but it's just something natural.
So did your friends introduce you to it?
No. Right here, so I'm gonna force nobody or introduce. You have to be a killer and you have to have a guts when you just make your come and return killer in a murderer. If you're a murderer and you have a talent, gear the road. Age doesn't matter. Look for me, I kill from a small. So you're different. My parent and what this. You have a mother and you have a father. So if a youth, a young 15, 16, 17, you're supposed to in a school out a door for your shop. Where you in a year also do your what this? To me, your worthless, or you should not turn your youth the right road. Him, if you decide to him not come out, him can come out then. See? What you think they build proof school for? Me not say on my mother or my mother saying me this a student about. For sure you say yo, my parent and worthless. See? You want them pick the building, even give a fuck about them picking the aspect. Picking them not going to give a fuck about them itself. Straight. My mother give a fuck about me. But what you know? She not there. Brother, my mother ever there for it. She not really know. People might be calling her and tell her things. She not really know really. See, I'm in a trouble. Me ever good. Me always good. Yeah, my mother here, you see. I mean, nobody is not going to call. I must be some informer auntie them. You know? What are your son? What are your son? Bumbuckler, she's not there. That I point. What she going to do? Father don't give a fuck. He tell me, say, if he dead,
fear up and dead and then get to a boat box, put me in a boat. I wait for him for blood clot, then he put him in another boat box.
The youth could have thought about anything, but him go straight to the source. And the families them, and the parents them are feel these youths. Me telling all the time, say, this is something I'm looking into deep. Because growing up, the same simpleton narrative where you probably accept, me like hear it too. And because the youth them poor, and they don't have money, and the youth them poor, where you think I can happen, I'm going to start. Until I started my own research, I started to look into the lives of some of history's most notorious killers. Not just in Jamaica, right? All over the world. I start to look at people like Ted Bundy, I look at people like Jeffrey Dahmer. I talk about man with youths who me know, right? From my own community where I grew up, come by and lose them life. I talk about people who I never know, but I know people who know them. And I ask the question, tell me about them background. Tell me about them family. It's the same thing over and over. Now, of course, Simple Simon, there's always some exceptions. There's always that one youth who actually did not come from an acidic home, and his mother and father was there, and he was raised in a loving home, and then he ended up becoming a... There's always that exception, but the exception is not the rule. The vast majority of youths who end up on the conveyor belt come from highly acidic homes. Right? They have beef with either their mother, their father, or both. If society could turn people into something, and a state could make the country one religion, we could talk about culture. Your culture, for example, the Amish people and them people, how do you think they maintain them culture in our country where, you know, everything else is completely different from them? How do you think they pass down traditions, mother, father, to pitney, to community? You can maintain any culture in any society. You can live in a Christian country and maintain a Muslim culture. You can live in a Muslim country and you can maintain an entire community full of Rasta. How is that done? Through the home, through the family, mother, father, community. The youth telling them, right, how this work. Parents, they work this. You see, your favorite politician can't say this because it's just not how you win votes. You win votes by saying these gang wars are going on, the 87s are going to Tredegar Park. They literally shot Pitney Pambres. The Klansman them take off Charmaine Ratchie and Joseph Lynchhead. And what happened, right, to people all over Jamaica? Because if the youths, they use them poor, if they just have money, we expect, they don't have money to use them at your yard, we expect. Complete rubbish. Jamaicans, right, have been living in poverty for decades, and in some of these communities, they've never even seen, right, a funeral unless somebody takes sick and dead, then they know a gunshot sound like, until recently. You hear what the youths say? Listen to him talk about his parents. Listen to him talk about his father. Listen to him talk about his mother. These youths, I'm telling all the time, most of them are unwanted, unloved, hugless children. No. We have to understand something. I always start with the conveyor belt, and I always so much keep youths off the conveyor belt. But once they go up on it, they have to be neutralized. I want to make myself clear. As much as I understand, say, certain people, them background, this and that, and them end up in that, they understand all of that, but the moment they start to kill people, you have to be neutralized. Just like how some people, they were abused when they were young, right? Of course, I can't even imagine what that's like, but if them grow up, come then, whole long woman, and whole long pitney and do all kind of things to them, sorry, but you have to be stopped. You have to go to jail, you have to this and you have to that. Right, so I want to be very clear. Not because your circumstances were unfortunate, not gain a blight, if you go start holding a woman, if you go start shoot up Tredegar Park, and no, you have to deal with that. This is why I said the best thing is to keep youths off the conveyor belt. I won't even realize how expensive it is to keep people in a jail. It's very expensive to the taxpayer, right? In my ideal world, no youths not going to jail. But if no youths not going to jail, no youths not go up on the conveyor belt. Because I'm going to talk about it. But once them go up on it, once them turn J-Bad, once them turn sci-fi, they have to be neutralized. In one way, shape or form. But let's not pretend like we don't know how these youths end up on the conveyor belt. That youth someone likes it. Let me explain something to you. Emotional intelligence. I keep talking about it, and you know people just think to me I throw around words. But tell them, I said the average 87 is a hyper-emotional girl clone in the Demar video. Let me say that a more sophisticated way. Most 87s, most serial killers, them have low emotional intelligence. They don't know how to process and deal with them feelings. This is why there's nobody quicker for killer than an 87. This is why the simplest thing will make a gunman feel as if they are dissing, even though there is no diss. When you realize that in Jamaica everything is a diss. The boy diss me when do, well me see him and me heal him and him heal me away, well like him a try diss me like him feel say him better than man, hey boy, me go diss them boy. You ever listen to 87 talk? What do you need to listen to how quote unquote bad man talk? Even people who don't kill, listen to all them talk. You're like, what you talk about bro? The reason why them sound foolish to you is because they have low EQ. They have low emotion, they can't deal with them feelings. Some things they must say they can't process it. Now, we can put that to children, we can put that to a young boy. A young boy reached the age of 12, 13. We know that most 87s grow in our home with their mother. We know that. They must have things happen to them and they must have certain feelings, but they must not process it properly. So you hear the youth say we turn killers into murderers. That line right there, so. It's probably the line of the video because I know some people confused. You see, that dude right there, so say something, right? He might not articulate it, right? The best way possible, but me understand fully what he mean. Him say them have a talent, them come to them a certain way, and then them start murder people. What he mean by them turn killers into murderers? You see, when I tell them about low EQ and them thing there, you know, if you understand, say, when somebody become a sci-fi, somebody will become a JJ Nakis. Somebody will become a bigger crime. Somebody will become a Ted Bundy or a Jeffrey Dahmer. They are killers before them start kill. And if not, listen to me. They are killers before them start kill. So when the youth say, they're not force nobody to do nothing, the youths come to them as killers and then they turn them into murderers. The murderers when them actually start take life. But the traits, the things they make them want to kill, these youths come to them join the gang with that already. I'm telling them, say, these youths are drawn to these gangs. Youths want the bad man, they want the killers, they have the urge. They cannot deal with them feelings, they cannot process their emotions. And them channel that in a badness. And then, on top of it, when them look around, all they must see is bad man a win. When them look around them in a film environment, all the ratings are go to bad man. Sci-fi get the most girl. It look appealing to him. So not only, him upset, him have rage, him want to deal with this. Now him see an avenue where he can go channel that. Then him start the killing. The first man dissed him then. You know, I was talking to somebody about JJ Nakis. And I never forget something what them said to me. Them say there's an infamous story where somebody tried to pay JJ Nakis if you go shoot somebody. Dispute go on, and they want to spot the secret, and they know say JJ Nakis always ready to kill. And when time them link him, them bring money for him. And when time them bring the money go give him, right? JJ Nakis' response was like, what that for? And the man was like, my gear money, right? If you go shoot person X. JJ Nakis laugh. Him say me kill people for free. You think that's a normal youth? You think these youths are motive? If they didn't have money, and if they grew up poor and the economic. JJ Naki say me kill people for free. The worst of the worst 87s, right? The bigger crimes, the sci-fi. When the youth drop, right, in a defense, me tell you how sci-fi get the name sci-fi. The man dropping at the, you know, the wire where them put on a fence and him something. The man dropping at it and sci-fi hold the man by a foot and push him back and forth, back and forth. Imagine what like, somebody's skin. You think these youths are more in the economy and in the money? The other hatches, these youths, no matter how much money they make, all they left Jamaica, they can't let go the badness. But as I said, look out for that video. Never show me this argument that you see when unemployment go up, then the crime complete rubbish. JJ Nakis and Sci-Fi don't give a damn about your unemployment rate. You can tell them say 5,000 jobs down at Spanish Town and it appears among them now go. Real hardcore 87 don't want no work. Killing is their work. In Jamaica, these youths, from these hugless, loveless homes, these youths who we know, people don't want to say it, but most of them are unwanted. So when they reach and they get an excess amount of love or attention, because anybody is supposed to be there, but they are planning for us, they turn up on our well, especially if they're like the seventh one in the house. Right? This another nine pitna might be a nice. No feel like my part of nothing. I feel like my part of something in a clan so. You see, I'm glad to say this video, the board. As I said, check out Preflix. Because I want thing when me say it, but remember, I'm a little YouTuber, though some views me I try to look. But when I hear from 87's mouth, the man said the parents they walk this. The man say one scene father in one box. Do you understand? How are you must look at life? They said that about the person who is 50% of the reason why he's alive. See, this is the real face of badness. This is when 87s show them real colors. Because when they end up on the corner, them talk wicked. Me no business about nothing. Man a bad man, a man no business about. But one time, you can cover them identity and then show them, say, nobody not gonna know you at all. That's when they show their real feelings. Check out the video. It's very profound. The man said we turn killers into murderers. That's the line of the video. For me. We got Preflix, excellent content. I'm still gonna support them. That's crazy to me. We turn killers into murderers. You would turn up in a Klansman, wah make a dopey. I've heard all the stories. When I ask the question, then oh the man they make them boy they come around them, then I run out the boy them. Run them away. You run them all 20 times, then come back 21. You run them 30 times, then come back 31. The youths, them, these youths are not, oh boy, the malnutrition, I'm going to kill this man, you know. These youths fight them way into the gang. There's a story about a stone crusher youth. The stone crusher man, them running away, they were like youth, yeah, juvenile. I think he was about 15 years old or so. The man, them running away. I know him, Godo. Find him own gun, open him own shooting. I think I need to do a video on a youth. Get him own gun. Go up on him own shooting. Kill man and bring back one gun, show stone crusher. Just to impress them. But let's check out the video. I don't want to talk about more site because I know say it's new to some people. Amazing stuff. Fascinating stuff. We turn killers into murderers. Anyway, if you transcribe you go from yourself. PIA don't know, no life. Ultra Squad, stay circling. Bless.